Hey, what's going on, everybody? Big Country here. Welcome back to Country Living. And hey, we have another one. Another RDA. You've heard about it. You know about it. Vandy Vape, the icon RDA by Mike Vapes. All right, guys, welcome to the first look of the icon RDA by Vandy Vape. It's a Mike Vapes project. This box looks really familiar. Deja vu? Oh, there's the GoVad. Pretty identical. But I tell you what, Geek Vape does the same thing in their products, and their products aren't identical. Let's just hope the inside's a little bit different. Alright, so we know this big old product contains nicotine thing is annoying. I got the stainless steel version, all the barcodes and authentication codes. Of course, the back says the feature, innovative build deck, easy installation, hedge air hole, speed the airflow. Hedge air hole, speed the airflow up, okay. General popular wide bore drip tip. I didn't notice this in the other. Is it? It's on there. It's just not as profound like the color. Yeah, it does say keep. This is funny. I don't know if you can see that or not. Keep the contents of this package out of reach of children, non-smokers, and animals. Non-smokers. That's funny. Vandy Vape everywhere. Okay, let's open this thing up and check out the icon. There it is, in all its glory. Vandy Vape logo, two additional drip tips. So there's the, what do they call it? The hedged air holes they were talking about. How they're kind of like just angled inwards. Vandy Vape logo. There's the icon logo. I like that logo. That icon logo is pretty freaking sexy. I like that. I prefer my logo on there though. That'd be cool. My square corner with the C in the middle of it. All right, Vandy Vape across the top again, and of course the drip tips. We've already been over the drip tips. They're all the same on these. They're both the same. All right, you got the pre-installed one that comes in as wide bore. Then you got the additional wide bore, but it's thicker. It looks like a thicker wall. And, of course, the smaller one, which is taller and thinner. Like I said, I like this option from the GoVad. I like the option. They supply three different drip tips. That way, everybody can get what they want. Nice big user manual. I don't remember the other one being this thick. Maybe it was. I didn't look through it, though. Oh, many languages. Okay, that's why they're so thick. It's not because there's a lot of information. It's just the same information repeated 100 times. This one's squonk pin. Icon can do squonk. Got a bunch of O-rings. You have a Allen key here. And the extra, this is the one. The extra screws in here are Phillips, which is what I will be using, the Phillips screws. Holy shit. I was like, why the hell ain't it screwing in? My daggone 510 is... It's out, way out. Is it supposed to be out that far? I mean, that's like way the hell out. I don't think so. I don't want to... There we go. Now the teeth are grabbing. Let's take this thing apart real quick. Because I don't know. So I don't want that thing to push. I don't want to screw it in too much to ruin anything, of course. There we go. It looks flush now. All right. Well, since we're here at the bottom, let's try to wash some fingerprints off for you. Let's go ahead and you got Icon, Mike Vapes Project by, what's that, Stefan's Signature. Manufactured by Vandy Vape, and a serial number, and again, mine is stainless steel, so it has the SS there. Build deck. Velocity style four. It's four hole system, but it's un. It's, you know, you got the ones that are kind of go the low here on the outside and the middle here. Now it's got a little thing here that they added through the final production to where it should help. Little lip here to where it could help keep your coil up in here instead of sliding down through there. That was a big deal during the beta, or through all the review models. But let's get these. I don't know. I might. Let's see. I actually have a new tool here, so which might help me with the hex screws a little better. So I think I'll leave the hex screws on here because they seem to feel pretty durable right now. 24 karat gold plated everything, it looks like, even the screws. Bottom of it don't, it looks like, that could just be residue because I want to throw this in the ultrasonic cleaner before I do anything to it, of course. It could just be residue on the bottom there. Let's hope so. Let's go ahead and look at the cap. The inside, of course, the conical airflow system or conical cap there. Like I said, the curved caps, it helps with flavor and vapor production. You don't have any corners to get things caught up in. But I'm wondering, you know, this adjustable airflow, cut it off by half or cut it off all the way. Does it go in single coil mode? That's what I'm wondering right now. It does. Yes, it does. Okay. See that side's open? See my finger through my skin? This side is closed. So this can do single coil mode. Okay, so what we're going to do, we'll go ahead and stick this into the ultrasonic cleaner for about anywhere from 5 to 10 cycles. Take about 20, 25 minutes, 30 minutes maybe. And we'll see if anything comes off of it during that time. And we'll come back, put a build on it, wick it up, juice it up, and vape it up. See you back here. For you, it'll just be a second, I promise. Okay, so I'll let this thing run through the cycle in warm, soapy water about four times. And then what I did, well, there's a Vandy Vape right there on the freaking build deck as well. And then what I did is I took the water out and put some clean water into it. And I ran it for about another three, well, between cycles, I went ahead and ran water over all these parts just to rinse off the soap. And then I let it run about another three cycles in clean water. And me being an idiot, you know, I said I was gonna do, initially, I was gonna switch out to the Phillips head screws. Then I said, no, these things feel kind of good, so I'm going to keep the hex head screws in there. And then me being an idiot, I pulled this thing out, because, you know, I left the screws in, I left them, or the hex screws in, and I left them about halfway in. And then as I was kind of shaking, I just kind of put it in my hand, and I just kind of shook it towards the ground, or actually into the trash can. I heard a piece of metal hit the side of the plastic trash can and go towards the bottom, so I lost the hex screw. So I only got three left, so I'm not going to dig in the bottom of that trash can right here to try to find that damn little bitty ass screw. So I got the Phillips heads in here right now. But I still see some grunge and grum. I guess it could be just machining, not very clean. Because it doesn't look like it's coming out even when I'm not scraping hard, mind you, but I'm rubbing my little screwdriver over it. I'm scared if I put too much into it, then it'll bring out the freaking gold plating, which is probably, I think it's just probably just not very smooth machining on the bottom of this. Because initially I thought it was just oil or something, but it doesn't seem to be because none of it went away. But everything else, the barrel, still a little wet. Top cap. Everything's been cleaned, so Let's go ahead and put a build on this. So I'm going to use today, I'm going to use these staggered fuse claptons. Stainless steel, 26 gauge cores with a 32 gauge wrap. Now I'm not sure what the ohm settings are for these. So I don't know if I can do duals or not, or if they wind up being too freaking low of ohmage. But I guess we will find out. If they wind up being too low of ohmage, we will do a single coil. Ohmage, is that a word? I will tell you one thing, these damn screws, these Phillips are pretty freaking big. Look how high they sit up off the deck once you get it done. All right, so let's see what this thing reads at. I know this thing ain't 100% accurate. It says 0.02 like it always freaking says. I can't wait till I get my good ones in. All right, so we're going to put this bad boy on the 350 for this evening. All right, so let's unlock it. New coil, yes. 0.163 is what it read. So let's take this thing down to about 40 watts. 241, all right, so let's let's work the coil, let's work our magic. Hope you can see that. Look at the color, man. You can see it. Try to get that color. That's what stainless does, man. Golds, the blues, and the purples. Okay, we got the cotton all wicked up, and today what we're going to use is we're going to use some of this banana shake from Milkshake Liquids. The funny thing about this is, on Instagram, I reposted a freaking gram, and I won this. I won all five of these freaking bottles from them. But I've been on a banana kick here lately. For some reason, I've learned that I love banana flavored juices. So, and this is really good too. I mean, it hit that juice or bananagasm from Mike Vapes was really good, and this banana shake is really good. So I'm gonna have a full review of the whole entire line coming up for Milkshake Liquids, so be on the lookout for that. But right now we're gonna sop it up. You know what, I should have probably used the banana gasm, being I am building on the icon. I should have his juice on here as well, hadn't I? That's what I should have did. But I bought a 30 ml bottle of it there one day last week. Got it on Monday, just so I wanted to see if I, you know, indeed did like the banana flavors. And it was only $14 on I think Elemental Vapor, wherever the hell I got it from. So I bought a 30 ml bottle of it. I've been about 4 or 5 days now, and it's just about gone. So yeah, I like it. I like banana vapes. Hit that juice, banana gasm was pretty good. Damn, I wish I had thought of that before just now. His juice and his RDA, I should have known what happened.
All right, so I do hope you enjoyed the first look of that. We are on our GX350. We're gonna be at, the build is a 0.16. And we are going to do this at 110 watts using banana shake from Milkshake Liquids. All right, here we go. First hit on the icon. Man, that hits pretty hard. That banana shake is good, though. Man, that banana. I love banana juices right now. Airflow is good. That airflow is good. The staggered fuse claptons. Combination of everything that I got going on this thing right now. The coils I got in here, of course, is on 350. And the airflow. Let's take the airflow halfway. That's hitting hard, man. That's hitting really hard. Whew. Warmth. I got some warmth. Well, of course I got some warmth. Not hot, but it's warm. All right, I'm going to do something that I haven't done. I got a fresh juiced up, still 110 watts. I got the airflow wide open right now. See that right there? Wide open. I'm going to do 150 is my normal. 110 is pretty much killing me. I'm going to go up, see if I can't do a 300 watt. I've never, you know what? I'm going to go 300 watts. I've never done 300 watt on this thing. Whew, I've never done 300 watt. Oh, suicide. This thing can go to 350. Should I go to 350? 300 watts. Whew, son of a bitch. That was only a half second pull. Oh, I got a Nick buzz from hell right now. Oh, all right, I'm gonna try to get at least a full second pull off this thing. Oh, I'm scared. See, still 300 watts, no cuts. That got hot quick. No. I did 1 full second though. See, you can look at my history. On the very bottom there, can you see it? 1.0 seconds. Ooh, I'm taking this thing down to 80. Because even a 110 was hurting me. 85, we're 85. Ooh, I mean, I hear, you know what's crazy though? I've been 120, 150 watt vapor for the longest time. But here on the Peerless and the Govad and now this, Oof. Maybe I'm just getting more adept to vaping and I'm realizing I don't need that high shit. My chest is... my chest, man. Oof. See, as I'm part of my office, I'm putting all my stuff back here on the mantle. That's a fireplace right there that goes into the living room. This office room or the bedroom, or this bedroom, was supposed to be. Shares the chimney or the fireplace with the living room. Well, let this thing cool down a minute because it's hot. It's hot. It is hot. All right, let's cool down. Let's take another couple last hits. And because this thing really isn't going to get its full workout until I get to the Fuche. Because I'm gonna team this up with the Sigelli Fuche 213. In a couple of weeks, because next week's if you saw the sneak peek from the other day on the GoBad video, next week's video's device is going to be the Predator, and then it's going to be the Wismic 300, which I'm putting the Rip Trippers Pharaoh onto, and then of course I've got the Wismic 23, which the GoBad is going to go onto. GoBag is going on the 2.3. The Pharaoh is going on the Wismic 300. The Icon is going on the Fuchai. So let's take a couple more last hits. A whole lot more comfortable. Still, great vapor. Great flavor. I'm not sure about the flavor part, if that comes from the coils or from this freaking banana milk. It's amazing. Either way, we're going to put this thing through a full test, and in a few weeks, you will have my final thoughts, full review on the RDA. So I do thank you very, very much for watching. If you did enjoy the video, please click the subscribe button and the like button. And let me know your thoughts about the Icon RDA by Mike Vapes in the comments below, and whether or not you are going to get one of these. I will put a link in the description of where I got this, because I honestly forgot what website I got it from, and I forgot how much I paid for it. I don't think it was no more than $30-$35 at the most, and I think it was off of VaporDNA or Elemental Vape, one of those two. But I will put the link in the description along with the price. Don't forget to check out the description as well down below. I got all my social sites in there. I got some advocacy information in there, and I also got information down below about my money. I got some sites you can save some real good money on, your juices and some devices. Thevaporsupply.com is a big one. They just launched a new website. You should have already seen the promo on that came up yesterday on Saturday. The promo trailer, or earlier today, rather. I think I'm going to post this icon. This is probably Saturday you're going to see this. But earlier today, you should have seen the promo trailer that I made up for the Vapor Supply. Chase is a real good guy. He's got the lowest prices in the industry. And if you use my code COUNTRY15, they get even lower. So go check it out. 300 watts is still affecting me. So go check out the vaporsupply.com. And if we can manage to get the Icon available on there or any other devices that I tried this week, I'll let you know. But if not, there will be links for the Icon in the description. And if possible, maybe get you a discount code to save you some money. So until the next video, I do thank you very much for watching. And just keep on vaping and living, baby. I almost forgot to mention that I have a new website. It is in the link description below, right around my social media, www.vaping. Matter of fact, you're going to see it right here, www.vapingandliving.com. No G's, just vapingandliving.com.